Welcome to your quick bite of cloud engineering. I'm Laura, and today we're here to chat about policy as code. So what exactly is policy as code? It's the idea of using code in some language, whether that's a general purpose programming language, a domain specific language, or a markup language, to define and enforce what can or cannot be done to a system through a series of rules and procedures. In short, it's a decision-making logic for your system, automatically applied. Policies by themselves are often run by hand, perhaps by validating things in a user interface like a website, and can be prone to failing when someone is tired or isn't aware of the policies in place. By having them in documents, there's potential ambiguity and misunderstandings by a reader who might interpret a sentence differently. By putting it into code, you get a ton of benefits. There is no ambiguity because code is interpreted only one way. You can use all of the standard tooling for code, from linters and unit testing to version control. You can ensure that it's running in every environment automatically by integrating it into your pipelines and testing procedures. And all along the way, you can be sure that policies are implemented correctly every time. If this sounds like something that is a good thing for security or compliance-focused teams, you'd be right. You can use policy as code to manage access control either via role or organization membership, validate that infra is created a certain way with tags or firewalls, prevent critical infrastructure from being deleted by a mistaken command, or otherwise provide automated guardrails for your organization. If you've ever done a compliance report, yay, annual audits, sarcasm inserted, or even an incident report, you know the pain when your guardrails haven't been that strong. Being able to use policy as code means your audit could be a lot less painful because you have a clear trail of activity and are less likely to have an accident to report. Policy as code isn't just for compliance, though. If you're worried someone might use an untrusted source for a container image, as an example, you can use policy as code to enforce where images can come from. You can warn about or even force a lockdown of network access into certain resources by restricting the use of public IP addresses or prevent certain types of resources from being provisioned to protect your network. You can even use policies to keep your costs low by using vendor-supplied APIs to calculate runtime costs and cap the resources accordingly. If you want to see what policy as code can do with an infrastructure as code tool, my colleague David, or Raw Code if you know him that way from the internet, did a lovely video showing how to use policy as code with Pulumi, which I'll link here and in the description. Overall though, policy as code has a lot of potential uses, and I bet you can name some more in the comments. This has been your quick bite of cloud engineering for this week. If you like this video, please share it. Sharing it and liking and subscribing, of course, helps out our channel and helps me make more videos like this for you. Also, if you want to learn about something specific, leave me a note down in the comments. I do read them. Or open an issue in our GitHub repo that I'm linking in the description. I'll be back in just 2 weeks for another quick bite. Take care. Bye. If you have a topic you would love to have us cover here on Pulumi TV, all you have to do is go to github.com/Pulumi/Pulumi TV. Thanks so much.